नमस्ते, वेलकम टू दिस चैनल केमिस्ट्री मेड इजी बाय डॉक्टर अशोक मुड़ी। वी वर डिस्कसिंग दिस सीरीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस। सो वी हैव सीन मोस्ट ऑफ द फंडामेंटल और द इम्पॉर्टेंट थ्योरीज फॉर एसिड्स एंड बेसिस। एंड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक स्पेक्ट्रा। सो दिस electronic spectra is also important in order to explain most of the times the behavior of a solvent when we are putting some solute in it, and in that case the behavior shows or the action of the this solvent on the solute shows the electronic transitions, and these are observed in terms of their colors exhibited, and on that basis we can explain how are these colors obtained and what kinds of transitions are taking place in these experiments or in these observations. So we will consider the example of here iodine plus donor and giving this product. So here iodine is Lewy's acid, means it is electron deficient species, and therefore it has tendency to accept the electron pair and get satisfied. Similarly, there are donor species which are electron rich species, and they can either share their electrons with the Lewy's acid, or depending upon the nature of the donor species, they can completely transfer the electrons also. And we can observe the detailed products about the product, and the product is called an adduct. So during this transition we observe that when iodine gains electron pair, it becomes minus, I2 becomes minus, and donor becomes positively charged. So this can be observed here in this MO diagram. So we can explain this behavior during the formation of adduct in this MO diagram. So we have taken the same example of iodine here. So this is our Lewy's acid, and this is donor is our Lewy's base, and this is an adduct. This is an adduct. So here if we observe the MO diagram, it shows that the electrons of iodine are observed here to be placed in higher energy molecular orbitals, such as here you can find 5p, these are 5p, these are 5p, and this is 9 sigma u star. This 5p is having sigma orientation or sigma bonding molecular orbital. It is labeled as 9 sigma g. Then next to it there are two orbitals of pi nature which are called 4 pi u, that is bonding molecular orbitals of pi nature. So these two and these three are a part of this 5p. But depending upon their energies, we have shown the separation. So sigma orbital is lower energy, pi orbitals, molecular orbitals are higher energy. Then there are also formation of antibody molecular orbitals of pi nature in iodine. So these are 4 pi g star. So these are bonding pi orbitals, these are antibonding pi molecular orbitals, and this is sigma antibonding molecular orbital. So it is labeled as 9 sigma u star. Here it is bonding molecular orbital of sigma nature called 9 sigma g. So this is bonding, this is antibonding, and this is bonding and this is antibonding. So these orbitals are shown here. So all these orbitals, this sigma g, the pi bonding, pi antibonding, are occupied, or they are containing, or they are filled with electron pairs. Now if we see the right side of this diagram, so we have shown the donor species and it has only one orbit which contains lone pair or which can be donated or shared with this Lewis acid. Now depending upon the energy of this donor and this energy of the acceptor, these orbitals, there is separation between the sigma and sigma star. So stronger is the donor, the energy of this will go down and energy of this, the sigma and sigma star will be, the difference will be larger and larger. So better the difference, energy difference between sigma and sigma star, we can understand that the donor is stronger. Further, if we see that this donor orbital is very close to this sigma bonding molecular orbital of this adductor, and these are orbitals of pi nature and there are no matching center orbitals, so these are directly transferred from this array to this adductor, that is molecular orbital system of adductor, and therefore they are shown here as they are. Similarly, the pi nature orbitals of antibody, that is 4 pi g star, also do not have any matching symmetry orbital, so they are also directly transferred to the MO system. So these are actually non-bonding molecular orbitals. Then this is about the donor and these are the molecular orbitals of a bonding nature and antibody nature. Now if we see that the transition is taking place from this 4 pi g star to this 9 sigma u star, it is called the I2 transition. So I2 transition is shown in this way, where the I2 and donor undergoes Lewis acid base reaction and gives the product, that is called the adduct. So this type of addition product is obtained with this MO diagram. So here we can observe the formation of such adduct species using various Lewis acids and Lewis bases. So here we have taken the different solvents or ions as donors, that is Lewis bases. So in order to explain this MO diagram, that is behavior, so this is generalizer or donor. So if we vary these donors, then we can understand what are the nature of transitions. So here we have seen the transition, which is explained here as I2 transition. And this is I2 transition. You can see here, which is taking place from this 4 pi g star to this 9 sigma u star. But here you will find another type of transition, that is called a charge transfer transition. So this transition is observed between sigma to sigma star. So when electron is moving from this sigma orbital, so we have shown this level, energy level, and this energy level, and this energy level is here. So when electron, this sigma electron is excited and it is moved to this sigma star level, then it is called a charge transfer transition. This is called a charge transfer transition because the electron can move from this sigma to this sigma. So it is called a sigma to sigma star transition. So this is called a charge transfer transition. But this is not charge transfer transition. Here the electrons are moving from the iodine one atomic orbital, that is molecular orbital of antibonding pi nature, to the antibonding sigma, is called I2 transition, and this is charge transfer transition. Sometimes the donor is so strong, sometimes the donor is so strong that it can transfer, cause the transfer of electron from this sigma to sigma star permanently. And because of this charge transfer transition results with the formation of the species like this, I2 minus and donor plus. So here you will find that the charge is completely transferred. Means the charge is transferred, means here you will find that how it is indicated that this sigma is composed of this donor homo. This is orbital. So this orbital is present here, or this sigma molecular orbital of product is composed of this species, and this sigma star is composed of this 9 sigma u star. Means during this charge transfer, the electron is transferred from this sigma, means more like from donor to the acceptor species. So charge transfer is the transfer of electron from donor to the acceptor. And if this transfer is completely observed, this electron is not coming back to this sigma level again, and it retains here, then this sigma to sigma star transition results in the formation of the ionic species, that is I2 becomes minus and this donor becomes plus. So in this way the charge transfer spectrum is also observed. Then we can observe the donors, that is using different solvents, so or ions we can see. For example, if we take the iodine formation of the product with this donor, if we use or without donor, we are not taking any donor or any solvent, so we are taking pure iodine, then it shows the formation of iodine vapors, and these are observed to be violet. Why it is so? Because you can observe here the spectrum, electronic spectrum is obtained by plotting absorbance against this lambda in nanometers. We have taken the 200 nanometer to 800 nanometer. The visible spectrum is from 400 to 800. So when the absorption takes place from 400 to 800, it appears in the form of specific colors. So these are visible to us. So this is visible spectrum of radiation. Then if you observe this iodine vapor, you will find that there is only one peak at near or around 500, but it is actually at 520 nanometers. So these are values in nanometer. So in visible region, you will find here that this 520 nanometer is the end towards blue region of the spectrum, that is visible spectrum. If we take the blue region of the visible spectrum, it is up to 400. So it is near to this lambda max. So this 520 absorption, nanometer absorption as maximum, so it gives violet color to the vapors of iodine. And during this observation of violet color, the color transmitted through this compound or iodine are yellow, green and blue. So yellow, green and blue colors, or where radiations corresponding to these colors are transmitted, or in other words we can show these are absorbed, you can see. But the visible color is violet. So here we are using no donor, means there is only iodine. Now if we take another electronic spectrum, that is with the same structure, iron is taken in hexane, and here hexane is non-donor species. Hexane is non-donor species. So actually there is no, means we can say no donation. Means actually the result is similar to this, because hexane is non-donor. So the color remains violet, as it is shown here without donor species. And in addition to this, here you have shown that lambda max is appearing at 520, same as it is. Means it is towards the blue region of the visible spectrum. So it is violet. Means it also shows that transmitting the radiations corresponding to yellow, green and blue, and the visible color is only violet. But in addition to this lambda max, there is one more peak towards extreme right in this diagram, left in this diagram, near 200 to about 400. It is called charge transfer spectra, which is appearing due to this sigma to sigma star transition. So it is appearing at 225 when the iron is taken in hexane. So even though the hexane is non-donor, it shows or it helps the transition called a charge transfer spectra. So in this case, there is this type of transition and this type of transition, same as near, but there is only one difference. Here is no charge transfer, here it is charge transfer. Then in case of this, another, if we change the benzene. So benzene has pi electrons, and pi electrons are also relatively donor, stronger donor than hexane compared to hexane or any other non-pi electron compounds. The benzene is pi donor. So here, relatively compared to hexane, it is good donor. So here you will observe that the lambda max appears more closer to blue end of the visible spectrum. Here it is at 520, here you will find that it is 500 nanometers. And the charge transfer spectra is moving towards this side, that is right side. So it appears at 300 nanometer of the this absorption line. So here the color visible of the solution is more red and violet, red to violet. So red violet color is more, means here violet color is relatively dilute, means it is less dark, and red color is more distinct. So this is because of the stronger donor species. Then in the third case, here fourth case, here donor is methanol, which is again more stronger donor compared to benzene, because it has oxygen like species which are strongly donor species. And here you will observe that the charge transfer spectra appears at 240. There is this shoulder appearing at 290, and this lambda max appears at 450. Is compared to this, this lambda max is appearing relatively more closer to this blue wave, that is up to near to 400 nanometer. So again it turns to be more and more brown or red. So it is giving you brown color. So in this case, the colors is appeared to be brown. And it is, why it is so? Because compared to benzene, it is more donor, stronger donor. And then if we take this water as a donor, if we use water as a donor, you find that the iron is less soluble in water. So it does not show much more stronger appearance of any color. So it gives only violet color. But when we are adding this aqueous KR, means actually when we are adding I minus to this aqueous solution of iodine, means iodine is taken first in water, and then we are adding KR, means actually we are adding I minus. So as a result of this, we get I3 minus IL. And compared to this, the I3 minus is also strong donor species. And because of this, the color is again brown. And the transmitted colors are being more and more like red and red, green and yellow. Here you will find that the transfer spectra is more close, but it is not distinct here. So lambda max is appearing at 360, means it is much more very close to the visible region of the spectrum. So you can find here that if we compare here, you will find that we have taken the example of iodine in general species as donor. So here, as a result of this, that the transfer of electron is donor to acceptor. So we are getting these species. But if we take the actual example of certain species, instead of iodine, if we take this Fe H2O6, instead of iodine, if we take the Lewis acid, this is Lewis acid. So we can name here as Lewis acid, and this is Lewis base. So if we take the Lewis acid as FeH2O6+, and if it is reacted with X minus in aqueous solution, like here it is I minus ions, then you will find that the adductor is obtained with the formula FeH2O5X-. And here the charge is decreased, 2 plus. So here Fe is with plus 3 charge. But after transfer of charge from X minus donates electron to this sigma star, that is FeH2O6. So therefore, this Fe is reduced from plus 3 state to this plus 2 state. So here, this X minus works as reducing agent, and itself gets oxidized, so it becomes X. So here we can consider the halides like F minus, Cl minus, Br minus, I minus. So here the increasing order of energies of this halide HOMO, so the energy of HOMO for F minus is lowest of all these. But every ion, even though FeF minus, is also a good donor species. So F minus is relatively having low energy HOMO. That is, this HOMO is low energy in case of F minus. Again, this energy of Cl minus is relatively higher. The energy of Br minus is again higher. The I minus is the energy is again higher. So this shows the complete transfer of electrons. The X minus shows complete transfer of electrons as the adductor is formed. So formation of adductor takes place with the formulation of the product with Lewis acid in the oxidizer reduced form. Lewis acid is reduced and the donor is oxidized. So here in this way we can find variety of observations. Then you will also note here that the transition, as we have already explained this transition, that is 4 pi G star to 9 sigma star. It is called iodine, that is I2 transition. Again, this charge transfer transition is taking place from sigma to sigma star. So, this is important to be noted here that charge transfer appears because electrons are completely or mostly transferred to the Lewis acid. Here, again, you have to note that the donor HOMO is here transferred to here, or this sigma orbital is composed of this donor, and this antibonding sigma star is composed of this acceptor, that is Lewy's acid. And therefore, you will find that stronger is the donor, the distance or the energy difference between the sigma and sigma star is wider and wider. If the strength of this donor is less, then the difference between the energy of sigma and sigma star is less. But with increasing the strength of the donor, the energy difference between sigma and sigma star is widened or increased. So, I think this is sufficient explanation. So, we will stop our discussion here and we will go to the next point, that is hardness of Lewy's acids and bases, in the next lecture. So, till then, goodbye. See you next time. Please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon and like button. Thank you very much.